Welcome to Bible study, everyone. This week we are looking at 1 John chapter 4, verse 7 through 12. We've been talking through this series, How Do I Know If I Am Saved? And over the last couple of weeks, we've been talking about God's work of regeneration and how that results in five different things in our life that are visible in our life. So, number one, a couple of weeks ago, we talked about how you will believe in Jesus. Number two is that you will repent of your sin. And number three, which is what we're going to talk about this week, is that you will love one another. So God's work of regeneration in your heart, in your spirit, in your life, results in these things. And one of them is that you will love one another. So 1 John 4, 7 through 12 says this: Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is made complete in us. So again, when God does his work of regeneration in us, the result is that we will love one another and we will grow in our love for one another. Now, we're not talking about like romance here. We're talking about a deep bond of affection, care, kind of like how you love your mom or your dad or your grandma or your grandpa. It's like the way that a father loves his daughter. And like he would give up his own life for her. So this is how we are to love one another. So I want you to imagine a father who loves his son. Man, he like teaches him how to tie his shoes, teaches him to skate, and even how to like hold the door open for his grandma and for his mom. And like they're good people. And the father like loves the son, and the son loves the father. And then one day, there's this trial, right? And there's this man, and he's facing the death penalty, and they're for crimes that he did do. Okay, so it's proven, he did it, and he's gonna face the death penalty. And at one point, the criminal even cheated that father out of some money, and so the father has to go and testify about him, testify about that criminal, and about how he cheated him. And after he does that, the father then actually offers up his son to take the death penalty for the criminal and like die in his place. And the son agrees with the dad because he loves his dad. That's what the father did for you. That's what God the Father did for you. And Jesus the Son loved you so much that he took your place. You're the criminal. I'm the criminal. And Jesus died in our place so that we could go free. Verse 10 and 11, it says, "This is love, not that we loved God, but that He loved us and sent His Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins." So what's interesting about this is it's not our love, it's God's love working in us, because God first loved us, sent His Son as an atoning sacrifice to pay the penalty for our sins. It says, "Dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another." So because God loved us, that's why we love one another. Because God's love transformed my heart, that's why I love others. So it's saying like it's not our love, right? It's God's love in us that is working through us. So if you are born of God, you will love one another, more and more. Not just your friends, not just your family, and not just people who are different from you, but your worst enemy, people who have flat out wronged you. You will love them, and you will grow in your love for them over time. Verse 12, it says, "No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us." So if you want to know, am I saved, right? Have I been born of God? Well, then you got to answer this question. Do I love one another? Do I love other people? Am I growing in my love for other people? It says, if we love one another, God lives in us. So do you have an increasing love for others? And do you feel that sense of compassion inside your heart? And are you acting on it? Answer those questions, and then you'll be able to understand better, like, am I saved? Because, again, the work of God's regeneration in your life and in your spirit is that you will love one another. You will love others, and you will grow in your love for others. So here's my challenge to you. To better understand this, I've got some homework for you. So what I want you to do is go and read 1 Corinthians 13. This is probably one of the most quoted scriptures at weddings. So everybody understands it in the terms of like romance. But I want you to read it in the mindset of like the way that a father loves his daughter, or the way that a mother loves a son. Okay, so to read 1 Corinthians chapter 13, it's a description of what love actually looks like, the way that Christ loved us. And then another challenge here, another piece of homework. I'm giving you a lot this week. Luke chapter 10, verse 25 through 37. It is the parable of the Good Samaritan. It talks about who it is that we are to love. Like, who is my neighbor? Jesus says, love your neighbor as yourself. And then he tells a parable to describe who your neighbor is. So when you think about love one another, well, I'm a pretty loving person. This is a story that Jesus tells in Luke chapter 10, verse 25 through 37, about who we are to love and who what it looks like to be someone who loves one another. So I want to challenge you to read those two things, comment, let me know that you've done it, and you know, post some of the things that you learned and discovered. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, and then Luke chapter 10, verse 25 through 37, and I will see you next week.